today we have Tina, and today we're talking about CFE, something that a lot of you guys have asked me. Let's start with your introduction.
Okay, so my full name is Tina Patricia D'Souza, and I hail from the state of Karnataka, from India. And we just recently moved to Canada, Toronto, and it's just been over a year. And I'm here with my husband, Nelson. So we both are in the field of audit. And coming to my educational qualifications, I'm an MBA with a specialization in finance. And based on my work experience and the career progression path that I plan to have in the future, I thought it would be good to do some specialization certifications, because later on down the path, more than an execution role, you're in the role of an advisor directly to the business. And I'd like to have the specialized knowledge to be in a position to provide that kind of knowledge to the business head. So with that background, I started pursuing all these certifications.
Yeah. And who would you recommend CFE to? Who should consider doing a course like CFE?
So to better explain that question might be, you know, my background as to why I chose CFE in particular to begin with. That would help. So when I was having a discussion with one of my colleagues with regards to, you know, what would be the ideal certifications to pursue, one of the things did come up, okay, CIA, that's a given, that is Certified Internal Auditor. But then I was like, okay, everyone is doing a CIA, that might be definitely something that I'm interested in the long run to pursue. But I also knew that I was interested in the fraud investigations and the forensic science. That's because within the Big Four, we have a dedicated team for that. And I had a couple of friends back then who used to discuss this entire scenarios that they came across. And it was so interesting. I mean, the way they actually study the entire financial statements, for example, and then they notice a pattern and how they actually, link it back to the particular person. Mm-hmm. Basically, it's like looking into the mind of a fraudster. And it's so interesting. And that's what actually caught my interest, that piqued my interest. And
what really are the what is the cost involved, and how much time does the whole process take?
So the cost would be anywhere between 1,200 to 1,300 US dollars. And so if you convert it into Canadian, it should be 1,600 to 1,700. Okay. And that includes enrollment into the institute, applying for the exam, getting the preparatory materials, all of that cost put together.
How much time does it take to write the exams, and how many exams are there?
So there are a total of four papers. So the first one would be financial transactions and fraud investigation, fraud schemes. Then the next would be legal, then fraud prevention and deterrence. And last is investigations again.
Okay.
A total of four papers, yeah. And each paper is 100 marks each, and it's an MCQ format question.
So how much time does the whole CFE process take? We spoke about four exams. So how much time does it take to write the four exams? And are there any scheduled time in the year that, you know, you can only write your exam at this point in the year?
Okay. So the best part of CFE is that you can write your exam whenever during the year. There's no scheduled period of time that you need to take your exam. So I feel that for a working professional, that's a great plus point. You're not stressed that you have to write the exam during this month. Right. And the second thing is that I really love this feature from the institute, is that you get 30 days in a month. I mean, that particular 30-day period. Within this 30 days, you can answer these four exams. So how do you plan to write it? Like, is it something that you want to pace it out within 4 days, or, for example, write one exam today and give a gap of 5 days to revise your concepts and everything and then write the paper? The institute gives you that flexibility as well.
Okay. But you have to do it within 30 days.
You have to do it within 30 days, yes. You have to do that within 30 days. And the entire examination, I actually took it from the comfort of my home. I didn't have to go to the institute.
Yeah. Okay.
So that's something good. Yeah, that's something good. And then another thing is that they do have a live proctoring session, in the sense that when you're answering your exams, you're getting recorded. And your screen is getting recorded as well. So that's how they ensure that you're not cheating on the exam, or you're not referring to any notes during the exam. So that's that's how they keep a tab on you.
What about the study material? Did you get the study material from the institute itself, or did you have to get it from some outside service provider?
So I got it from the institute. From the institute, they provide three options. One is the CFE exam prep course.
Okay.
With the material. So along with the prep course, you get the e-version of the fraud manual.
Mm-hmm.
So what I did is actually went for that option. It is pocket friendly, as well as it has the entire concept very well provided to you, in the sense that the entire prep course is modeled after the actual exam format.
Mm-hmm.
So while you're studying, you're testing yourself in that environment, in that simulated environment. The other two options are, there is a 4-day expert training, institute training, mm-hmm. that they provide. So within the institute itself, they have listed all the institutes within Canada, in fact all across the world, that actually provides this kind of a facility. So you can enroll for the that intensive 4-day training, and then they also give you this option of writing the exam on site. That is, if you feel comfortable to write the exam right away, you can do so. But before you actually go in for that 4-day intensive training, they will give you this list of material that you need up, that you need to read up and prepare for before you come directly for the training. So that's option two. And the third option is, like, you have to sit and read a 2,000-page fraud examiner manual all by yourself, which I personally feel is more time consuming and too overwhelming as well if you're completely new. The one thing that I want to call attention to with regards to the prep course is that they have something called as a money pass back guarantee.
Ooh.
So what happens is that if you're able to meet the entire eligibility criteria within the money pass guarantee facility, in case you do not clear a particular paper, you don't have to file the re-exam fees again. So the ACFE Institute gives a waiver of that fee, and you can take another retry.
Okay.
So I believe the retries are limited up to 3 times. So that's a good facility which you get within this option. It's not there in the other two options.
To enroll into the program, do you need to have any educational degree, like a bachelor's or anything, or no requirement for that?
So for me, since I had completed my master's, it was pretty simple. I got it, like, straightforward. But I believe that the minimum educational criteria is a bachelor's, or sometimes they do consider bachelor's while you're studying a bachelor's plus some work experience as well. But once again, it depends on the management discretion, is what I would put.
Yeah.
If they find that it actually makes up for it and it is enough for their to satisfy their eligibility criteria, they can actually go ahead. They can give you a go ahead to pursue that education.
Okay. And how do you rate the difficulty of the exam? Like, what is the difficulty level?
So since I had my since I had prior exposure to the world of fraud, in the sense that when we do our internal audit back with the Big Four, they used to ensure that we do a fraud risk assessment. So for each and every area, we had to come up with what are the different fraud vulnerability areas. So I had that prior mindset and understanding, and I had read up back then.
Right.
Yeah, so my only criteria this time when I was sitting and studying, I had three papers were simple and easy. It was like brushing up concepts for me. Financial transactions, I'm like a major in finance, so I knew that. And then fraud prevention, detection, and then investigations were simple for me. I've already done that.
Yeah.
My weak area was legal, because I had no exposure to the US legal law.
Right.
Yes. Yes. And so I would suggest that would be my weak area. So once again, difficulty level, I would not be giving the right picture. What I would say.
It really depends on people.
It depends on the person. If you've had prior experience, this should be simple for you.
I'd want to know, what is your advice to all the aspirants? If you were to give them any tips for the exams, or people who are confused between CIA and CFE, what would be your last thought for them?
Now, for people confused between CIA and CFE, if you're pretty new to the world of internal audit, I would suggest start with CIA first, so that your foundation in internal audit is strong.
Okay.
And then you move on to CFE.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a very logical step to take, is what I would suggest. Don't do the roundabout way.
Yeah. And I don't think less than, you know, in these few minutes, anybody could surmise and put a whole course together. So you've done it so effectively. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
For any questions, I'm going to drop her LinkedIn link below. She's also been working on some articles that she has been posting out for CFE. If you have questions, do reach out to her, and there are a lot of details on the article as well. So thanks again, Tina. Wish you all the very best.
Thanks, Nidhi.
Keep doing the great
thank you. Thank you. And thank you for this opportunity as well.
Thanks.